we're being very, very, very wishy-washy on the research methodology, intentionally for that matter, okay? Intentionally. And I want to focus only on what their conclusions are. Here's another one. I think. Maybe, oh, there we go. Jake's like, yes, yes, I concur. This is one of my favorites. I actually have some extra resources. I might make an in-class quiz out of this one for us to do. It's a Stanford study. It's great. Very, very cleverly done, I think. This is becoming more and more of a problem. And as a bike commuter, I deal with this on a very deadly level. Number of times. I'm firmly convinced that COCC students in general cannot start their cars without their cell phones in their hand. I'm almost positive of it. And as a bike commuter, I deal with this quite a bit. But the reason I kind of Googled this result in the first place is I watch my wife, who can watch television, have an intelligent conversation with our 7-year-old, and balance the checkbook all at the same time. It's an amazing thing. Now, that doesn't prove anything. That proves that she can do it. And it proves that my measurement of can do all of this well might be different than a scientific researcher's. They might look at her and go, yeah, but she was off by a cent. In which case, I go, who am I to blame? I'm off by dollars, usually. But what they did was they set up a very, very interesting study, similar to this one over here with confidence intervals, that showed that people that multitask got fewer precise and accurate responses on an assessment than those who weren't. Of course, we had to define what a multitasker was. And Anna, they did one better. They defined zero multitaskers, low media, and high media multitaskers. And they did one better, something I hadn't even considered, which was totally badass. So they did define that. Very nice, thank you, sister. What else would they have to make sure? And this is something that we tend to forget sometimes. What did that? Go ahead, Chris. Go ahead.
What's considered good multitasking?
Yes.
And bad multitasking?
Right. What's considered success on an assessment? See, we're very often Americans suck at school. We always hear this, right? Americans, we're in the bottom third in the world in math performance. Bottom third in math performance. You guys have heard this all the time, right? I mean, maybe the percentage changes, but we always suck. That's just we're a sucky math culture. Has anybody bothered to ask what assessment they're using to assess that? And maybe the countries that are doing really, really well are just better prepared to do that assessment than we are? Has anybody bothered to ask that question? Have you ever heard that question asked? Good. You should. Because you're putting an awful lot of faith in that number. And if that number is not 100% correct, this is why I hate Oaks testing. And I'm scared where Common Core is headed in the same respect. Because unless the assessment that you're testing with, you are pretty much without a shred of doubt married to and trusting in, the number that comes out is useless. The politicians love it, of course. Oh, Oregon tested 48 again. Cut the funding again. Did you see the assessment?
Have you read the questions?
Have you read the questions?
Me.
Yes.
And I'm a college student.
Somebody, well, and some of them are so big. As a person in my 105 class, her daughter or her friend's daughter had a question. Susie was counting like this. 177, 178, 179, 180, 190, 200, 210, 211, 212, 213, 214. Why would Susie count like that? Well, there is not one correct answer for that question. Is there a legion of people reading the answers to check for how good the answer is? I know why I would count like that. If I had small piles of things and individual things, I start counting them individually, and how the hell with this, and I start in my mind grouping them in tens. But knowing how my mind works, it would get tired very quickly, and so I'd go back and like, the hell with it. You've seen me do this in class. When you guys raise your hands and put number of fingers up for the number of times you get something, and I start going like one, two, and then I'm like, 10, 10, and then I'm like, shit, 2, 3, 4, 5. I do it all the time. That was my answer. But that's my answer, right? Who's reading the answers and putting, so my point of this is, you gotta watch assessments. Make sure that number that you're counting is a valid number. It actually means something. Okay, back to the big picture though. What do you think they went in? So there was a control group in this too, non-multitaskers. Here's their confidence interval. What's the belief of the people that are doing this study at Stanford? How are multitaskers going to compare in their heart of hearts?
They're not going to do good.
They're not going to do as well, right? So in their belief, in their heads, where is the interval going to be with respect to the control group's interval? In their heads and in their hearts. over here, right? So if we, can I go over here again? I'm gonna use a visual. Thank you, Elizabeth. I'm with you on that.